In this tutorial, we will create 5 different text animations in After Effects, so let's get to them. I will be using 1920x1080 30 frames per second composition for every example. For the font, we'll use Montserrat Black with a size of 200 pixels that has center text paragraph. Just keep those in mind. Now here we are in the first example, and there's no animation, so let's go ahead and create one. First, let's expand the properties of the text, click the Animate button, and select Position. Then you will see the Add button appear, click on it, go to Property and select Opacity. Now we're going to increase the second position value to bring the text down, so maybe something like 150. And then we're going to set Opacity to 0%. Let's expand a Range selector, make sure you are at the start of the timeline. Create a keyframe for Offset by clicking the stopwatch and set it to negative 100%. Let's move 1 second forward and set it to a positive 100. Now let's expand Advanced Settings. Set Shape to a ramp up, then set Ease High to 25% and Ease Low to 100%. Now if we do the preview, we should have a very smooth and elegant text reveal. So definitely one of my favorites. Let's now get to the second example. I'm going to open it, expand the drop down of the text, click the Animate button, select Position, click the Add button, Property, Opacity, then click the Add button again, Property, Tracking. Now we're going to bring the text down once again, so that was 150 that we used previously. And before we use opacity, let's decrease the tracking amount to crunch the letters together like that, so negative 110 should do. Then set opacity to 0%. Again, make sure you are at the start of the timeline. Let's expand the range selector 1 and create a keyframe for start this time. Click the stopwatch at 0%, move to 1 second and set it to 100%. Now drag and select these keyframes, right click any of them, keyframe assistant, easy use, or press F9 as a shortcut. Now while the keyframes are selected, we're going to open the graph editor, right click here, I'm using speed graph, so make sure that's checked to so the graph looks similar. I'm going to select the first point, then you will see the yellow handles, I'm going to drag both of them all the way in, then exit the graph editor, and here we should have a very snappy animation compared to the smooth that we created previously. Now let's head over to the third example. Again, expand the settings, click the Animate button, and this time I'm going to select the Blur, then click the Add button, Property, Opacity. Now, before we use any opacity, let's increase the blur until we cannot tell what the word says, so something like that, 150. Then let's set opacity to 0%. Again, at the start of the timeline, we're going to expand Range Selector 1 and create a keyframe for Offset, set it to negative 100. Let's go 1 second forward and set it to a positive 100. Expand Advanced Settings. Again, set the shape to be ramp up. And for the Ease High, we're going to leave it as 0%. And Ease Low, we're going to set it to negative 50%. Now, if we preview, we have a simple blur animation. But if we enable randomized order, this will give us kind of a cinematic type of animation, if you will. Now, let's head over to the fourth example. Again, expand this. Click the Add button, I'm going to add Scale, Add button, Property, Opacity. I'm going to set Scale to 0% and Opacity to 0%, then expand Range Selector 1, create a keyframe for Offset and set it to negative 100, go to 1 second, set it to a positive 100. Now expand Advanced Settings, set Shape back to a Ramp Up, now set Ease Low to 100% and Ease High to 25. And here if we do the preview, we should have a very smooth scale animation, which you would see a lot in motion graphic type of work. Now let's jump to the fifth example. For this one again, let's expand this, click the Animate button, and we're going to select Tracking, then Add button, Property, Opacity. Here before we use any opacity, let's decrease the tracking amount to crunch the letters once again, so negative 110, like that, then set opacity to 0. Expand Range Selector 1 and create a keyframe for start at 0%. Let's move 1 second forward, set it to 100, drag and select the keyframes, press F9 to ease them, go to the graph editor, and do the same thing, pulling these handles all the way in, exit the graph editor, and let's preview this. So this way the letters animate from the center, it looks like they were like stacked together, and they're quickly expanding to the sides. So one important tip here is you could add motion blur if you would like the text animation to be even smoother. So here, if we enable motion blur, you can see that the whole animation will be a lot smoother. So now I'm going to go back and add motion blur to every example and we can preview them again. So this is the first one, enable motion blur. If you don't see this color, click toggle switches on modes until you do and you'll see the motion blur. So check this one, Make sure this one is also blue so you can see the motion blur. So this is the first one, the motion blur. The second one. Third. Well, to the blur, you can't really apply motion blur, but, you know, still. Let's go to the fourth one, enable motion blur. And here is the last one. So using motion blur is completely up to you, but I generally use it because it makes everything smoother. And those were some of my favorite text animations to create in After Effects. If you'd like to see more awesome text animations, do let me know in the comments and make sure you like this video. Thank you guys for watching. See you in the next one. Peace out.